Hey, hey, and welcome back to my Let's Play series, A Sparkling World. And today we'll take a look at the station building on the village side, and we also continue our work here. So let's do this. So as you can see, I did quite a lot of building on the station building itself, and I also made a tower next to it with our station building employee. He's a cartographer, so I have not traded with him yet, so we can still change him if we want. I also started on the inside already. It's not finished yet, so we got some storage, crafting table, a lot of open air. I really like that. The only thing that we're missing is extra rails, like the powered rails. And the levers to swap them from side to side, some buttons to send them on their way, and we also need to make an exit for the villagers to leave, so I'm not yet sure how I want to make that. For this part I closed off with some fences, so we don't have any villagers moving out or moving in. But the thing with the rails is that I need gold for that, and also some iron, and we're almost out of everything, so we'll have to do a mining session. We also need to do some gathering of oak and some white mushroom blocks, so we can also finish the carrot farm over here. So yeah, we've got a lot of work to do today. And if we have time, we also will do something with this entire area in here, and maybe also the wall around it. So let's get started with mining, gathering materials, and then we're going to build over here. So I'll see you in a bit. So I'm done with my mining session, and we found quite a lot of iron and gold. We also explored that mine shaft for a bit, and we found some nice spawners. Even a double spider spawner, even though there are cave spiders, it's still really nice because we don't get any string yet, and we will need that to make scaffolding out of our bamboo, so I'm really happy with that. Yeah, furthermore, I also found some gold, which we're melting up right now, so we can make some powered rails for our station building. And yeah, I'm really happy with this, because that means that we can make a better mob spawner XP farm, because yeah, this one is not working that great, because I can't stand here, because I'm too close to the spawning platforms. So we'll have to reinvent this or build another one. So yeah, the double cave spider spawner, you'll do really good for that. So let me melt this up, make some rails, and farm some mushrooms, and we'll be off to building again.
So we're back. As you can see, we did a lot of work. We did already some landscaping with the in the garden, some bushes and the tree. And so the rest of the episode I want to spend on making a planning for the rest of the village. So we're going to do another time lapse, but this time we're going to remove all the homes of the villages that we have now, except for the ones that are our villagers inside. And yeah, then we'll see how far we can get with the planning. So let's do this.
Thank you.
So, and I'm back. As you can see, we've done quite a lot. I moved all the trees and all the homes and everything in between, so we can see what we're working with. I also placed in the beginnings of where I want the wall to be. But I need a lot of more dirt to make everything entirely flat and whole. And then we can start our planning and building. But since I'm running out of time, I think this will be it for today. It's a little bit of a shorter episode, but I hope you still enjoyed. So I'll see you next time. Bye bye.